Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 4th of 2020, well, it is titled The Wizard Nebula. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of an emission nebula, and it is popularly known as the Wizard Nebula, and it's also known by its catalog designation of the star cluster within it, which is NGC 7380. And that's a very young star cluster, only a few million years old. Now, while we tend to think of a few million years as a long time, in terms of a star cluster, that's very young. We talk about stars like our sun being 5 billion years old, and other stars pushing up to 10 billion years old or even more. So a star that is only a few million years old is actually very, very young. This cluster is about 1/1000th the age of the sun. And that means that we still see it within the material from which it formed, and that is the gas and dust around the star cluster. And that is the leftover material from star formation. And when that material is heated up by hot stars that have formed, stars that emit a lot of ultraviolet radiation, then they are excited and caused to glow. And here we look at what we call a narrow band image, meaning that we are looking at only three specific colors of light, and that is the light that is being emitted by hydrogen, oxygen, and sulfur. And those are transformed into the colors we see here, the hydrogen into green, the oxygen into blue, and the sulfur into red. So we're seeing where those specific elements are being excited and caused to glow. And this is where we learn about star formation by looking at some of the very earliest stages of a star's forming. We can see some of the dark dust clouds scattered around this image as well, dark dusty areas where star formation is still going on. We can see the young star cluster and areas where stars again continue to form and stars that have recently formed. So studying the star formation and the evolution of stars is not something that an astronomer can do by studying a single star and watching it go through its life. In order to be able to study the evolution of stars, we have to look at lots of stars at different stages and use that to piece together the evolution of an entire star. It would be similar to trying to study the evolution of a human in a single semester class. If you want to study how a human goes from birth through death, you're not going to be able to see any significant changes, for the most part, during, say, a 3 or 4 semester class. However, if you look at all the different stages of different humans, you can then piece together how the human might change over the course of their lives. And that's one of the things that we do with stars. And this is one of those earlier stages that we see here, the very earliest formation of some stars. So that was our picture of the day for September the 4th of 2020. It was titled The Wizard Nebula. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Moon Landing. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.